Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Five pilots from the NYPD sure gave people quite a laugh after they left a massive message in the sky during what was perceived as a feud with their boss and a protest involving conditions that may not have been safe to fly in. The message was detected on flight tracking software and supervisors notified the boss, aviation unit head Inspector James Cohn, according to the New York Post. What was the message? It was a giant penis. The pilots flew their planes in the shape of a giant penis and the shape, pattern appeared on the flight tracking program. Many might have laughed, but the pilots faced consequences for what they did. What was the pilots' reasoning for doing this? They were protesting unsafe flying conditions as they questioned if the federally funded plane was safe to fly at low altitudes over water. They were reportedly concerned about crashing into the ocean if a propeller stopped working. Hopefully, they achieved safer flying conditions for pilots after them. Five New York police pilots who were feuding with their boss flew a $4 million counter-surveillance plane in a giant penis-shaped route in a bid to troll him. Trending, town's entire police force suddenly quits over what they were all forced to do. The phallic flight pattern showed up on the NYPD's tracking system back in March when the pilots opted to protest against aviation unit head Inspector James Cohn, the New York Post reports. Supervisors monitoring the flight tracking software immediately alerted Cohn when they noticed the penis shape. Two of the pilots were removed from the unit as a result and the others disciplined after a departmental hearing. The pilots staged the protest after they questioned whether the federally funded plane was safe to fly over water at low altitude. They were concerned about crashing into the ocean if a propeller happened to blow. The pilots said they were ordered to start carrying out the flights in July last year. Cohn reportedly increased the number of runs in March. Any of the people who complained about the mission, they got the ST end of the stick, a source told the Post. They had to do all these menial tasks outside their job description, including washing Cohn's car. The NYPD agreed in May to stop the missions until meeting with union representatives. The plane in question was the same one the NYPD used to shuttle Mayor Bill de Blasio to and from vacation in Canada last month. The flight pattern probably looked like the one in the follow video, which is obviously phallic in nature. If I was a pilot who was told to wash a supervisor's car, then I might be a bit distraught over that. That's not what pilots are hired for, right? I'd also be upset if I was a pilot who expressed an opinion about a potentially dangerous situation and was blown off. It's a shame that the pilots are being punished for this and not Cohn. He should be the one to lose his job because it seems like he was abusing his powers. If a pilot tells you they feel unsafe flying a certain aircraft in a certain way or location, then the supervisor should listen to them. The pilot and passengers are at risk and those lives are important. Maybe it doesn't matter much to the supervisor who isn't on the plane, but it should. Cohn should take the pilot's opinions into consideration and accommodate them when they feel unsafe. At least listen to the pilot on why they believe flying a particular aircraft that low above water is a bad idea. When you notice that the plane only had the one propeller in the front, then you have to understand why it was a bad idea to fly low over the water. What happens if the propeller stops working and the pilot is too low for the water? That means they won't have time to glide themselves to a safe landing area. Hopefully, the situation with the NYPD pilots improves and the supervisor realizes that his pilots are very important and very much needed. Pilots are important and their opinions on safety should matter. Note from the editor, the views and opinions expressed in this article are those of the authors and do not necessarily reflect the position of this website or of the owners, administrators of where this article is shared online. Claims are made in this piece are based on the author's own opinion and not stated as evidence of fact.